You are fully aware of the circumstances that led to the enactment of the National Cohesion and Integration Act, number 12 of 2008, under which the National Cohesion and Integration Commission was established as a statutory body. Hence, there is need for you to be very diligent in carrying out this assignment. Under our Constitution 2010, commissions as envisaged are not only expected to function independently according to powers conferred upon them, but should also exercise high level of responsibility. This therefore calls for a meticulous undertaking in the selection of holders of these offices. As patriotic Kenyans, which I know you are, I believe you are all familiar with the critical provisions of the National Cohesion and Integration Act, number 12 of 2008, which I'm sure you have read and understood, which will not compromise as you undertake your assignment. Particularly, I wish to draw your attention to number 18, the qualifications of commissioners, where Part B stipulates that the person should be of very, very high moral character and proven integrity, and C, that the person should have knowledge and experience in matters relating to race, ethnic, and human relations and public affairs. Objects and functions of the commission. Kenyans will be looking forward to you coming up with a short list of nominees who will contend with the work outlined in this section. And you will agree with me that the work outlined here is not for the faint-hearted. Right. You need to be truthful so that Kenyans will be convinced that the men and the women you have selected for them are fit for purpose. They are fit for the job. Qualify in all circumstances to be the stewards to steer the NCIC forward. Kenyans will rely on you to recruit persons who will have the capacity to exercise the powers given to them without fear or favor.
You have already created a picture of the type of person we need to recruit, so I'm sure they have already some idea of. Of course, they had, these are experienced people, but you have added to that by giving a picture of the type of people we want and the type of situation we are in. As a commission, we have been endured without commissioners for the last 1 year and 1 month. Mainly, I think most of you are aware of what happened. There has been, you know, the National Cohesion Integration Act, the original law was challenged in court, and Parliament made an amendment so that we can have a panel. So we are looking forward to having those commissioners. Of course, I'm not going to tell you the importance of commissioners. You are a commissioner yourself, other than driving the policy. In our case, we are even unable to sometimes prosecute cases. And you know, we have some enforcement work to do in terms of hate speech and what. And because of the past precedent which was set for the Ethics and Anti-Corruption Commission, it has been difficult to prosecute hate speech cases. That does not mean that we have not been doing that work, because we have been using some innovation. Because I have police officers in the commission, so we have been using police powers and what to carry out that enforcement. So I thank you very much for having set the process, and we wish the team the best of luck.